All right, the second episode of In the Life of Paranormal Investigators. It is 29th of November and yesterday was my birthday and thank you so much for the wishes. In this episode, we are going to talk about what we call or what India calls as Asia's biggest paranormal convention, ScareCon. You already might have seen the after movie. And the photographs, if you have liked us on our Facebook page, which is fb.com/pairsindia. If you have not, then please go and check it out. The photos are amazing. Everyone loved the event. But what we are going to do, what I'm going to do right now is show you or talk to you people about what happened behind the scene, how the preparations went, what made us organize an event like this in a country like India, and a lot more things. So the whole idea of ScareCon was to bring all the horror fans under one roof in India. We keep organizing events, for example meetups or other events where we gather certain amount of people and we talk about the paranormal, but ScareCon is like a much bigger event. It's like an annual event, like an annual function for the paranormal fans here in India. And so it was, I think, two years back, 2016 and 2017, 2018. And me and Pooja were watching the San Diego Comic Con, and we were watching the Supernatural TV series panel. And we saw that 3,000, 4,000 people all gathered to watch their favorite stars. We were talking about that particular TV series or about that particular genre. And we thought, why not have something like this here in India as well, but not as something else, but in the genre we are good in, the horror or the paranormal. And that is when we started planning. 2018 went like a random, plans were made, as in we had zero money in the bank account, we had no idea how to do it, it was happening for the first time, and we just took the call, let's just do it. And that's how we started working, and gradually people started coming in, as in to support us, to support the event. We got a team ready, 5-6 people, and the entire event was organized within a month, I think. And it was on October 28th or something like that in 2018, and it happened at a private banquet hall, and we had 100 people to attend it, which was a big motivator, as in motivational thing for us to like, it was a green signal that yes, people are open to these things. But 2018 was, you know, we just had two panels and we had three speakers, and it was like a 5-6 events, and people came and they enjoyed and they left. But when 2018 ended or was going to end, we decided to take 2018 ScareCon to another level. And when I say another level, we had zero idea what to do in it. And I think because we had nothing in our mind, we had nothing prepared in our mind, that is what helped us to make 2019 successful. So when we were preparing for 2019, we were all ready to we had to keep a certain amount of time to reach out to the people, because for an event like this, where paranormal is the genre, horror is the genre, people always prioritize it, it's not a very easy task to hold events in India that are paranormal or in the horror genre. But that is not something, not an obstacle. We don't see that as an obstacle. We just see that we have to change that particular thing. And we had it on November 3rd in 2019. And the preparation started around 3 months back, as in August, September, October. All 3 months, entire month were gone in the preparations. We booked the World Trade Center, which was again a different, just again something that was giving out a message that we are not getting satisfied by organizing it small, we are doing it big. And that's why we got the World Trade Center in Kolhapur, South Mumbai. So that was the first step. And gradually as the days went, we decided that we have to design the entire thing. So we had 3-4 people in the team, that includes me and Pooja and our treasurer and you know, the lawyers we have, for example, Apuva, or we have Amit, and we have other people, Savio and Shiva and other investigators who are core members of the organizing team. And we all, you know, we got in a group discussion and we decided what to do and how to do. And we come to a decision that we are not going to buy any props. We are going to make it apne aap, as in khud baith ke karenge, because we knew their prices, and because it was happening during Halloween, the budget could have just, you know, went to a different, on a different level that we might not have been, that would have been impossible for us to reach. So we decided, let's just make it at home. We went through a lot of videos, we did the, you know, DIY videos, so then we watched all of them and we started making. So if you watched the after movie, or if you have watched the photographs, the props that you see that are used in the venue, the entire thing, as in I will say around 95% of the props that you see were done by us. It was designed by us, and as in it took a lot of time, but it was fun because we were using our creative mind to it. And everyone is creative in their own way. So we all put together, blend it, and acha khasa juice bana ke humne. We designed all the props and everything, and that's how the designs went. Now another plan was to take all the props to the center, to the venue, just a day prior. So it was 2nd November, and we took the props to the World Trade Center. Now that was a mess, it was a messy thing to do, because we live in New Mumbai, and the props were in New Mumbai, and we had to take it to South Bombay. And but we hired a car sort of thing where we can load stuff, and we had to go by Uber or something. We reached the venue, it took us around 5 to 6 hours entirely to install it. But that was not the only thing that was going on 2nd of November. The guests we had were totally of a different level this time, as in they were popular, they were amazing, they were doing their awesome job in the horror genre. So to name a few guests that we had Vishal Puya. And if you have watched the Criminal Justice or Bombers on Z5, or if you have watched the Marathi movie Lappa Chappi, then you know who is Vishal Puria. Vishal Puria is the director of all these movies. He was on board. We had Siddharth Jain. Now Siddharth Jain is the creator of Ragini MMS, the iconic cult horror movie. And he's also the founder of The Story Inc., which means his company adapts books to screen. So all the movies or the web series where you hear or where you see that this web series has been adapted from this particular novel or book, it is his company that does the job. And then we had K. Hari Kumar. Now K. Hari Kumar is the creator of Bhram, that is now streaming on Z5, and is the author of India's most haunted book. And then we had Jitendra Power. Now Jitendra Power is the director of Trip to Bhangad movie that is now available on Netflix. And then we had Vikram Khakkar. Vikram Khakkar is the producer of the movie that featured Randeep Hooda, Main Aur Charles. Then he did Dobara, which is the official Hindi remake of the movie Oculus. And then his upcoming is with Arjun Rampal, again a supernatural thriller. We had him on board. Then from the authors, we had Faraz Kazi. Faraz Kazi is a national award winning writer. We had Kiran Manral, who is awarded by UNICEF and whatnot. And then we had Neil De Silva. Neil De Silva is the author of the two books that we that will be releasing, our two books that will be releasing in 2020, which we'll be talking in other episodes of In The Life. We'll have a detailed talk on the books. And then we had Suhail Mathur. Suhail Mathur is our literary agent and one of the founders of the Bookmakers and the authors of various amazing books. And we had this. Then we had members from the Indian Paranormal Society that was founded by Gaurav Tiwari. And so it was like we had three panels this time. We had amazing speakers. We had Chetna Chakravarti, who is a life coach and a biotouch healer. And we had Taranam. Taranam was a fan favorite last time, and this time also we got her who had a talk on the psychic in everyone, the psychic in us. So this was a guest thing, but apart from that, we also had planned that people will get bored, because what we were planning is an event that was around 8 to 9 hours long, and we thought there should be some entertainment thing to keep people sit tight and enjoy their particular event. So we had a team by the name the Super Core team, that is headed by an amazing guy named Prasad. And his entire team took the responsibility to entertain the people by a drama dance thing, which was really amazing again. So all these things were planned, but now the date was November 3rd and we are all nervous because it was for the first time that a paranormal event is being organized at such level, with a venue this big, so iconic, with the entire place designed or how do I say, propped with haunted objects or you know, skeletons and katewe haath, katewe sar, a lot of things were happening. We also made a room people had to go through to enter the convention, but finally it happened, and it's November 3rd, we are all set, the team is all set, and we are finally waiting for the people. The people come in, and this time we had one more additional thing, we had stalls. So we had the Bollywood Crypt, who sells merchandise, they had a stall. We had stall from the authors Neil D. Silva and Kiran Manral, and we had book launches. We launched two books at ScareCon, that was India's Most Haunted by K.R. Kumar, and The City of Screams, that is India's first horror anthology that had around 10 to 11 authors. So we launched those two books. We also launched the trailer of the movie The Hexing, that had an international cast, and we had a panel of them. So a lot of things were happening and were planned, and it did go well, but it also gave us an idea that people are certainly open for such kind of events. In 2020, we have already decided, we have already started planning. We are going to make ScareCon a 2 days affair, which means it will be for 2 days. I think the dates are 31st of October, 31st of October and 1st of November. And this time, this year, as in 2020, it won't be in the South Bombay. We will try to get a venue somewhere in Andheri Bandra side, so that more people, interested people, can flock in and enjoy the entire events for 2 days. And you can imagine, for 9 hours event, we had so many speakers, so many amazing people. You can imagine what we can do and what we are planning to do in the 2 days event. A lot of stalls, more stalls will be installed, more things, maybe workshops and everything. We have a plan ready, which I'm not going to share for sure, so that it can be a surprise for you people. But yes, the dates are out. It is 31st of October to 1st of November. Uske aage peeche will be having many other things that we are still in talks, which I can't share right now. But yeah, the entire week will have something or the other. And yeah, we'll be taking the paranormal community here in India, or the horror fans here in India, by a storm. And people are going to love it for sure if they loved this one. And many people congratulated us after the event. The guests loved the event, the entire setup and everything. And yeah, so a work that took us more than 3 months finally yielded some good results, in a way, by getting appreciated from the people, the guests and attendees. And yeah, that's why we are keeping ScareCon 2020 a 2 days event on 31st of October and 1st of November. That being said, if you are a regular follower, then yesterday we uploaded a paranormal investigation video that we did at one of the most haunted locations in India and Maharashtra, the Holkar Bridge in Pune. What an amazing investigation. The things that we got, the spirit we communicated, it was... The spirit was from the 11th century. I'll not say more. I'll just link the video somewhere here on the top. And please go and watch this video and leave a feedback or a comment if you liked it or not, because the investigation was really overwhelming for us as investigators and the things that we captured and the things that we saw and the things that we heard. And we had, we got 4 words from one of our devices, and the words were cupboard, 11th century, tape and slave. So these are the 4 words we got during our investigation, and on the next episode of this particular segment in the life of paranormal investigators, we'll have Pooja, you'll have me, we'll be talking about what we think these 4 words could mean, because we believe and there is a link to all these 4 words that we got during the investigation. So the 3rd episode is going to be amazing, but for that you'll have to subscribe to the channel and keep liking our videos and keep sharing our videos, and that's how we are going to get more things. Just to let you know, we have a lot more things coming up for this particular segment. Like I said, we have a lot of travel plans and everything, and we'll cover all those things and get more topics to talk to you people, because this is more like I said in the first episode, is more like a casual talk, more of a raw talk, where we don't have to don't have to care about the lighting or the sound or anything. But you people liked it, so yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, like this video as well, and do comment down below if you want if you know any place where you want us to investigate. But before that, go down to the previous video and watch that particular video, and even Vikram Bhatt is interested to watch that video, so yeah, you should as well. Thank you so much again for watching it, and we'll see you next week. But I think uske pehle aage piche kuch hota rahega. I have no idea, no plans of investigation, because we are still finding the locations. But this particular segment will be coming every Friday. So thank you so much. Have a great day if it's night for you, and great night if it is night for you. See you next Friday. Bye bye.